Hey there, everybody, and welcome. In this lesson, we're going to learn the basics of the gradient tool in Adobe Illustrator. I'm going to go ahead and get started by accessing my gradient. You can do that in a few different ways. One way is you can go down to your colors panel, and you'll notice that you have three little swatches underneath your foreground or your fill and your stroke colors. You have, in this case, I have purple because that's what I have selected. But if I click this center one, I will have access to my gradient, which immediately will pop up my gradient panel in which I can select the different types of gradients that I want to use. Right now, I have a linear gradient, which is essentially white on one side, as you can see by pulling these handles, or black on the other side. As I move these handles, I'm changing the location of the gradient, and this little diamond at the top plays with the distribution between the two dots. If I wanted to add more colors, I would simply hit the bottom gray area, add a color, and continue to work. So I could go in and double click and add some color in here if I wish. If I don't like that, no fret, I can go ahead and get rid of that by hitting the delete button as well. So this is our linear gradient. We have a radial gradient, which works a very similar way. Once again, you can do that. I can go through and adjust these colors as I see fit, depending on my style and what I'm trying to create. I can use my eyedropper tool even. Very, very forgiving. I can go out here. And when I click my eyedropper tool, you'll notice that I get the gradient handle. Another way to do this, if we're starting with blue, is to go to your gradient tool itself and hit G on your keyboard. If I go ahead and click on my element with that, I will get that same gradient handle. This handle works in a cool way because you can actually click and drag the handle to get custom gradients. All of these sliders work very similar to what you just saw in the gradient panel. We have the two little dots, as you can see, for distribution, and then we have that diamond for smoothness. We can also rotate that gradient by left-clicking on the outside element. A really nice way to kind of build gradients. And if you ever need to access that gradient panel, you can just double-click on it and the old school panel will come up. The third type of gradient is a freeform gradient, which is kind of cool. It just essentially allows you to use different points and kind of the fill and stroke mentality to kind of change those up and just adjust as you see fit. So we can scale that little icon there to play with the distribution. It's essentially a four-point gradient, for lack of a better way to say. We can switch to the line mode. The line mode will allow you to draw lines where your gradient is going to be. If you have a specific area in which you want that gradient to follow, you could go ahead and do that. That's your essential gradient tool. Kind of moving on, we can do a lot of fun things with gradients as well. Gradients are a great way to add a little bit of dimension to a flat vector object. For instance, here, if I get my gradient tool and double click, I can go ahead and let's move this. We'll drag it from the bottom here. We can go ahead and add the illusion to this water droplet that it has some dimensionality, which is really, really nice. You can see I'm adding things here, but one thing you may notice is I can't add more than one gradient. Well, there's another tool that can really be helpful for this. That's called the gradient mesh tool. So I'm going to reset my fill here. We're going to find the gradient mesh tool. If you look in your toolbar, if you're using the standard toolbar, you're not going to see that right away. But if you hold your left mouse button down, it will actually appear underneath the gradient mesh. It's U on your keyboard. The gradient mesh tool is a really powerful tool because what this will allow us to do, if I click, it's going to create this mesh around the area. If I use my direct selection tool, I can grab these different points and I could change the color fill of those. You can see here, I can adjust the fill there. I can grab multiple points by clicking and marking. So I can grab a couple here. Maybe we want this to be more of a bright spot. I can continue to build and add to this mesh. If we want a little bright spot over here, absolutely can do that. Now we have that little bright spot. And we can go in and then just play with the different handle tools to play with that distortion. We can get a lot of dimensionality rather quickly. And this works really well with any type of object. You just want to have a basic understanding of contour. You're going to want to kind of think, in this case with the apple, where are my contour lines? How is it kind of rounded out? And again, having some fun with it is always encouraged. I can take these and we could add, We can add a little bit of light color here just to get that dimensionality of the apple. At any point, I can go ahead and do kind of go through and add the dimensionality of the apple, which is really, really nice. Gradients are also really cool to act as masks. I'm going to go ahead and use my standard gradient tool, G on my keyboard, and I'm going to drag. I'm going to double click this a few times to get it to activate. We're going to kind of rotate this. And I'm going to double click on the gradient. I want a linear gradient in this case, and I want to change it from up to down. So I'm going to rotate that 90 degrees, and we want to reset this to black and white. I'm going to reset this to black. Great. That's going to be white. Now, another really cool thing is I can set this to transparent. If I hit transparent here, I want to show you real quick before I go and mask this out what this looks like. So now I kind of have a veil. A lot of people don't realize you can create transparent gradients, which is a kind of a really cool factor. But in our case, we're going to use this as a mask. I'm going to make sure that that is actually fully 100% filled in. Black conceals, white reveals. So what we're going to do, we may even flip this gradient. There we go. Just so we can hide the bottom, is we're going to create a clipping mask. So if I highlight both of these elements and go to Object Clipping Mask Make, you're gonna see, well, not a lot happened, right? But depending on my layer order here, so if I go to my Layers panel and I find the Hide Me and put it on top, and depending on how I select them, we can now create a clipping mask, and it's going to fill that in a little bit, which is a really nice starting point. So that's going to kind of essentially mask that out. If I go back to my gradient, for instance, and I double click on my gradient tool and I change some of these settings and the opacity, you're going to notice it's going to start hiding that specific shape. How cool is that? So in this case, it kind of works a little backwards. The black is actually showing it slightly where the white is kind of hiding it. But now we have a pretty transparent shape here. When in reality, if I move this out of that clipping group, it's still a basic kind of colored in shape. We can use gradients to act as a mask here in the artboard, which is really helpful. The final thing I want to show you isn't necessarily a gradient, but it's a really cool effect that kind of gives gradient possibilities. I'm going to go to Effect, 3D Materials on this heart, and we're going to choose the Inflate material. That's going to open up a inflate element. As you can see, it actually creates, which is, I'm just moving my left mouse button, a 3D heart. How cool is that? This gives me the ability to add things like lighting and play with intensity and rotation of lighting. It gives me the ability to also add shadows. This looks pretty kind of raw and flat until you go to this button in the top right. Here, we can actually render this and hit render. Depending on your computer, this is going to take a little bit of time, but it's going to render a really nice gradient on your final object. You can see gradient use, it's really, really amazing the diversity that you can get in Adobe Illustrator. That's all for our lesson today. It was a quick one, but I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you can see ways you can use gradients in your workflow.